Welcome to the 8x8 lecture series on architectural theory. This series shall bring set of 8 lectures of 8 minutes each on important aspects of theorizing architecture. By end of 8 lecture series, you shall be equipped to understand the basic nuances of architectural theories and its relevance in practice and academics. The first lecture attempts to articulate the basic fundamental question on what is architectural theory. Before we articulate what is architectural theory, let's begin with the most popular myth related to understanding of architectural theory. The lecture will attempt to decode the myth and carry out fundamental questions and understanding of what is architectural theory in order to break away from established myths. Let's talk about myth and misconception related to architectural theory first. Architectural theory is same as science theory. Architectural theory is a prescription for action. Architectural theory is a justification. Architectural theory is only for academics. Architectural theory, theory of design, and architectural criticism, they are all same. Well, none of the assertive statements mentioned above are true. Science theory, which are tested and verified with scientific methods, and is moving towards tangible rationality, it provides norms and prescription for action, and it follows linear timelines. While architectural theory is not a prescription for action, architectural theory are about speculation. It's speculative in nature. It means that any position in architectural trend or nature of architecture at any given time can be subjected to criticality at any point of time in future with newer means. Architectural theories are not justification, rather it's an intellectual discipline locating relationship of self and society. So the question is how architectural theory comes about. How to do one articulate architectural theory? First, the architectural theory is a discussion, debate, and writing on architectural trend, pattern, its issues, or repertoires of ideas either from within architecture using architectural language or from other disciplines. In either of the positions, it attempts to obscure the cult of individualism, that is, biased values. It brings about discourses of knowledge and virtues within moral responsibility towards society. Architectural theory investigates the method of critical, interdisciplinary, and outward-facing research. Architectural theory speculates on past and present simultaneously and influences the process of making of architectural practice and pedagogy. Architectural theory is an epistemological position, a knowledge structure that shapes architectural theory in order to position critical dimension. The strength of architectural theory depends on one's ability to bring various contextual understanding in writing on architecture, what we call it critical writing. There are also issues with the three terms, theory of design, architectural theory, and architectural criticism. Theory of design brings about fundamental principles of design. It's visual language, or a tectonic language, or a discussion on aesthetic judgment, or tangible aspects of design. For example, Form, Space, and Order, written by Francis Ditching, brings about some interesting way of diagramming architectural form. Architectural theory brings about nature of context and manner in which they are manifested and its relevance either in the time they were produced or in contemporary times. For example, modern architecture, critical history written by Kenneth Frampton, it brings about discussion on architecture of an industrial and post-industrial phase. Architectural criticism is a broader spectrum of architectural theory, which engages the value system of other disciplines to be able to situate architecture critically. It often takes polemic or dialectic situations based on wider perspective or wider responsibility of architecture. For example, Architecture in Utopia by Manfredo Taffi. It brings about political dimension of utopian world within modernism. While learning architectural theory, we often start from theory of design with a basic understanding of tectonic language and slowly expand into architectural theory with larger questions. While architectural criticism widens up and critically examines the value system of architecture with the value system of other disciplines, but not necessarily reducing the scale of argument within theory of design domain. Architecture has always existed with the binaries, which has always been problematic in architectural learning. For example, binary of practice and academics, or theory and practice. The binary creates autonomy in understanding and producing architecture, which is also problematic as architecture is for society and not for individual consumption. We need to make every attempt to dismantle such autonomical structure of architecture or should not allow resurrecting. Though architecture in contemporary time has reached the stage where it is difficult to resurrect its autonomy, architectural learning, practice or writing have elastic boundaries of speculation. It has to reach out, connect and absorb as many ways of looking, appreciating and critiquing. Perhaps the lineage of contemporary practice often intersects with many other disciplines and find its relevance in our time. So the theory is a bridge to imagine newer forms of architectural practice in emerging times. So I hope that this basic understanding of architectural theory has come about through this video. We are going to bring the lecture series constitute of 8 videos, namely Modern Construct of Thought, The Social Construct of Modern, Technological Construct of Modern, Representational Construct of Modern, International Construct of Modern, Stoic Construct of Modern, and lastly, Ethical and Moral Construct of Modern. Thank you.